Welcome to another replay by Angus, and as you can see, I have gone completely mad. Completely mad because I have an artillery replay for you. I hate artillery. I rarely play them because, I'm just completely opposed to them. But at the same time, playing artillery can be hell of fun. Let's get the show on the road. As you're about to see. So first thing I'm going to do here with the bishop. The bishop has very short range. That's it. That's the range. First thing I'm doing is checking out the range. So, because I'm actually... This is one of the very early games I've had in the bishop. You'll notice that actually in front of me there is a Panzer IV Hydrostatic. So that's a fairly rare tank. I don't know how that person got their hands on it, but good on them. Anyway, one thing about the bishop is that it's not particularly quick. Right, let's see. So that red circle, the mods that I've got there, is telling me the range of my bishop. So it's telling me that that T-46 that you can see on the map is too far away, so I have to get closer. It's a problem with the bishop, massive problem to be honest with you, with the bishop and the FV304, but the FV304 at tier 6, bishops at tier 5, manages to get away with the problem because it's so damn fast. The bishop, as you can see, is not fast. It's not a fast machine. Alright, here we go, there's a T-40 right there. Okay, let's see. Now, I have fitted a gun laying drive and an artillery gun rammer on this boat. Well, that's a miss. And that was always going to be, so I don't know what I was thinking. But just look how small that circle ends up being with this tank. Bang! 182 damage. That's an open top vehicle, so that is going to hurt. Anytime I hit him, that is going to hurt. Fire again. Last known coordinates, and I've killed him. There you go. T-34. Okay, he keeps moving around. He stops to shoot.
Enemy hit.
Bang, 126 damage. Nice. And because I've got about an 8-second reload, so I can reload faster. Basically, these guys are shooting. Yep, that went in. Didn't see the explosion, so it definitely hit him. Which means, oh no, there he is, he's back there. Okay, one more, can I get him?
Gotcha.
Two kills, nice. Okay, there's a KV-1 up here. So zooming in nicely. And, that's a problem, of course, with artillery on heavy tanks. Sometimes you'll hit them and you'll do hardly any damage. Now I'm thinking about, can I get both of these in the one shot here? Forget it, just go for the KV-1, that's the dangerous one, but clean miss. M2 medium. Can I do something about the M2 medium? Let's just drive the engine deck on the KV-1. Can we do that? No, we miss. Okay, medium's gone anyway. Still shooting at the KV-1. Waiting. Go.
Enemy hit.
Okay, got him, tracked him. Okay, holds them in place. Once they've used their repair kit, I can reload before they can get their tracks back up. That's the amazing thing about this gun. Got him! There you go, three kills. T-14 down here. Okay, zooming straight in. Have a shot at these last known coordinates. Ah, he's not there anymore. Hello, T-49. Yep, three hit points to go. I just have to splash him. He's moving around. Got him. SU-85B, so that's 4 kills. Here we go. Come on, SU-85B. There we go. Open top vehicle. Good night. 5 kills. I'm on an absolute rampage, but we're losing 8-10. We've lost the field. Basically, it's only this heavy tank area that we've got. We're holding it all. Yeah, not looking good. So at this point, I figure I have to move up. So I do so, watching for that BDR. But I don't have a shot. I have a mountain in the way. Which is a little frustrating, but there you are. That's why that was never going to work. So I'm futzing around here. Trying to see what I can do. The T-14 is showing his face, so... Ah, it's gone again. Ah, there he is, he's back. Okay, come on, come on, come on. Can we get him? Let go. Right, he's moved. Nicely done, actually. Just kept moving. I think he's backing up there. Come on. Oh, he's been tracked. Okay, this is going to hit him.
That was close.
Oh, that wasn't much good. Okay, that was a splash for 20, but it did track him. So hopefully... Can I get him again? Yes, I got him. Okay, he's moving though. I just need him to stop. Just need him to stop. If I can stop, if he stops, I can hit him. I'll have a guess. Nah, no good. Well, there's BDR right in front of me. Have I noticed it? Yes, I have. Okay. BDR is trying to take on the head, so this is no good. Damn it, damn it, damn it. Okay, he's reversing back into my line of fire. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
That was close.
Okay, damn. Right. Now, take him down. Gun's pointing the wrong way. He's not pointing at me anyway, so another shot.
Great shot.
Here we go. Just gotta keep this gun singing. I'm the only one left now. Just gotta keep this gun singing until my ultimate and obvious demise. Yep, that hit him. Somebody is capping. What am I gonna do? Yeah, this is not good, right? BDR. Well, I've done my bit. I really have. Okay, BDR's coming up over this hill. Where is he? Come on, come on. Oh, I'm being shot, but BDR moves into range. That's a top gun. SU-76 nails the kill, wins the game. No, actually it wasn't. It was a Matilda. So, yeah. Good job, guys. Although, oh man, that was frustrating. I did my bit. Got myself a top gun. 915 damage at tier 5 is nothing to sneeze at. Especially in a 350 hit point machine. Wasn't enough. Just wasn't enough. In fact, I was the only tank on our team that scored more than one kill. Oh well, let's have a look at how that game went. Here we go. So that was a first-class mastery badge. I did 1,500 damage, actually, a lot more than XVM was telling us, and 561 assistance damage, which would be basically when I tracked them. First-class mastery badge... High caliber, Reaper, Master Gunner, Sharpshooter, all the good stuff. That's 730 XP in a losing side. Yeah, and nearly 30,000. Nearly 30,000 credits. So, let's have a look here. Yeah, so base XP of 487. For a loss, 1,500 damage, 6 kills, which means fired 22 shots and hit 13 times. In an arty, you'd take that any day of the week, wouldn't you? 13 penetrations, 5 splash damages, and 1,000 damage done at more than 300 meters. The range isn't that much more than that of this tank, so yeah, you'd be happy with that. So, let's see. So, I destroyed 6, damaged 7, 561 assistance damage, and didn't travel very far at all. Ah, I did get Courageous Resistance, an extra nearly 5,000 credits, but What you gonna do? So near, and yet so far. Anyway, this is Angus signing off.